Namaste children. In the previous classes we discussed in fractions regarding multiplication of fractions. Of we discussed in the previous class. Of indicates multiplication. Okay. Now today we are going to discuss exercise 2.2 sum question. So I am going to explain entire this first question. First question I will explain all the 4 bits. Second question you will do in the homework. Okay. Now let us see this here. Which of the drawings A to D show? There are 4 drawings are there. A, B, C, D. Based on this, we have some questions also is there. First question, second question, third question, and fourth question. There are 4 bits are there in question number 1. Okay. Now let us discuss first one. Okay. So the given product, it is multiplied. Okay. So I told you, if you want to multiply, that fraction is repeated that many times. So here 1 by 5 is a fraction, 2 is a whole number. So now here 1 by 5 is repeated 2 times. Means there are 2 circles or 2 squares or any 2 other figures. Out of those 2 figures, in each figure they took 1 part out of 5. Okay. Now first of all you have to see that this denominator part. First of all you have to see that denominator part. What is the denominator here? 5. Okay. Now come to the figures. In which figure have 5 parts? See D. So the answer will become D only. Okay. See this here. Question number 1. First bit. Solution. They given 2 into 1 by 5. That means here 1 by 5 is repeated 2 times. 1 by 5 is repeated 2 times. Okay. So now, see this here. The denominator is 5. So there are totally 5 equal parts are there in one figure. So how many figures are there? 2 figures are there. Okay. So there are 2 figures. In each figure we have 5 equal parts. Out of 5 equal parts, 1 part is shaded. So this is 1 by 5. This is also 1 by 5. So 2 into 1 by 5 is equal to 2 into 1 by 5 is equal to 2 by 5. I told you, how to multiply. This is 2 into 1. Whole number into numerator. So that is 2 by 5. What is 2 by 5? This is 2 by 5. When we merge. Okay. And draw the figure further. Which is implies. So draw one circle. Draw one circle, divide into 5 equal parts, 5 equal parts, then shade 2 parts. So this part and this part. Okay. Now this is nothing but 2 by 5. This is 2 by 5. Out of 5 equal parts, we took 2 parts. That is the process to do a given question. Now let us see second bit. What is second one? 2 into 1 by 2. Second bit is 2 into 1 by 2. So there are 2 halves are there. 1 by 2 is repeated 2 times. Now you have to see that 2 parts. In which figure have only 2 parts? In this 1, 2, 3, 3 figures are 3 parts are there. In this 2 parts are there. B1 is the answer. Okay. See the denominator part. You should get idea easily. Okay. Now here 2 parts are there. These 2 are squares. Out of this 1 square, we are divided into 2 equal halves. This is 1 by 2, this is 1 by 2. Repeated 2 times. So they are merging, we will get 1 square. So this is 1 by 2, this is 1 by 2. So therefore, 2 into 1 by 2 is equal to, 2 into 1 by 2 is equal to, what is the value? 2 by 2. That should be, which is equal to 1 representative. 2 by 2 means 1 representative. Okay, so now draw the figure, which is implies, what is the figure here? By merging both the squares, you will get, this is part 1, so this is a lines I am shading this one, and as well as this part. Okay, I understood, did you understand this? Right, I think you have understood this one. Okay, so what is the second one answer? Is B bit. First one is A1, first one is D1, second one is B1,
Now let us see the third one. Third one is 3 into 2 by 3. So 2 by 3 is repeated 3 times. 2 by 3 repeated 3 times. Okay. Now see this in which figure I have 3 equal parts. 3 equal parts. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 3 circles are there. Each one is 2 by 3. Each one is 2 by 3. In each figure, you have 2 by 3, 2 by 3, 2 by 3. So, 3 times it is repeated. So, this is 2 by 3. This also 2 by 3. This also 2 by 3. Clear? Now, third one is. So, 3 into 2 by 3. This is equal to, I told you how to multiply. 3 2s are 6. 6 by 3. 6 is a multiple of 3. You can cancel 1, 3, 1s are 3, 2s are so it will become 2. That means you will get, when you merge these three circles, you will get 2 full circles. Okay? Understood? See? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Totally 9 parts are there. When we merge, you will get 6 parts means 2 full circles. Okay, so this part I am going to shade it here and this part I am going to shade in here. Okay, now you get 2 full circles. Means 2 full circles. Each have 3 equal parts. This is for your convention, you are drawing the figures. Then you can understand easily. Okay. Understood everyone? Right now, yes. So here, by taking like this, you can see it. Clear? So what is the answer here? The third bit answer is A. The third one is the answer is A. Now finally, the leftover part is only this one, fourth bit. Shall I explain here? Because I have no space there, I am going to explain here for fourth bit. Now you can understand it. Fourth one is what? 3 into 1 by 4 means there are 1 by 4 fraction is repeated 3 times. 1 by 4 fraction is repeated 3 times means there is a figure which have 4 equal parts. There is a figure which divided into 4 equal parts because denominator is 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 3 figures are there. So each figure have 1 by 4, 1 by 4, 1 by 4. This is 1 by 4. This is 1 by 4 and this also 1 by 4. Clear? 1 by 4, 1 by 4, 1 by 4 repeated 3 times. You will get 3 into 1 by 4 which is equal to, by multiplying 3 into 1 is equal to how much? 3. 3 by 4. When we merge these 3 squares, when we merge or combine these 3 squares, it will become single square. The figure will become like this. In single square, you have 4 equal parts. Out of 4 equal parts, 3 parts are shaded. 1, 2, 3. So this part, I'm taking this part. Okay. You understand? 3 parts out of 4, 3 parts are shaded. The fraction will become 3 by 4. Answer is C1. This is clear, my dear? See, observe the given fraction first of all. First one is, the denominator is 5. Means see this in the given figure which have 5 parts in figure. This one, because in this circle, there are 5 equal parts, they divided. Okay, out of 5, 1 part is shaded. That is 1 by 5. So, 1 by 5, how many are there? There are 2 1 by 5s are there. Means 1 by 5 is repeated 2 times. That's why 2 into 1 by 5. So when we merge these two, when we combine these two, we get figure 1 circle. Into in that 2 parts I'm shading. Okay? Now B bit, second one, 2 into 1 by 2. 2 into 1 by 2 means 1 by 2 is repeated 2 times. Where is 2 parts? Here 2 parts are there. Okay? In this is the square and they are divided into 2 equal halves. Here also they are divided into 2 equal halves. Each part is 1 by 2, 1 by 2. When we merge these two, you will get one single square. Both the parts are shaded. That's why we got one representation. It is one whole. The
entire part is shaded. Okay, now see third one. 3 into 2 by 3. 3 into 2 by 3. When we multiply 3 into 2 is 6. 6, 6 by 3. 6 is the multiple of 3. Okay, 3 ones are 3, 2s are 6. So 3 2s are going to be cancellation. You get 2 is the answer. Okay, just keep it in mind. This is very important. Here, there are 3 circles are there. Those 3 circles, they divide into 3 equal halves. 3 parts. 3 parts. Each circle, they divide into 3 parts. 3 equal parts. Out of 3 equal parts, 2 parts are shaded. That is 2 by 3. Here 2 by 3. Here 2 by 3. So 2 by 3 is repeated 3 times. So when we merge these 3 circles, we will get 2 full circles. We get 2 full circles. Clear? Now coming to fourth one, 3 into 1 by 4. Here 1 by 4 is repeated 3 times. 1 by 4 is repeated 3 times. Now see this here. The denominator is 4, means 4 parts. See this figure. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. There are 3 squares are there. Out of 3 squares, 1 part is shaded. That is 1 by 4, 1 by 4, 1 by 4. When we merge these 3 squares, we get 1 square. Out of 1 square, 3 parts are shaded. Okay? When we merge these 3 squares, we get 1 single square. In that, out of 4 parts, 3 parts are shaded. That is 3 by 4. So, first one answer is D1. Second one is D. Third one is A. Fourth one is C. Okay? Now, let us discuss one more question. Now, children, so in the previous, before this, we discussed the first question. They given one whole number and a fraction, and they given some pictures. We match those pictures. Now, see this here. Question number 3 in your same exercise, 2.2. Multiply and reduce to lowest form. Lowest form, we discussed in 6th class already. Lowest form means we need to reduce into simplest form. Okay, right? And convert into a mixed fraction. If it is simplest form and if it is an improper fraction, then convert into mixed fraction. There are some questions out there. I am going to solve these 4 questions. The remaining we will do homework. Let us see. Second question. Third question, second grade solution. I am going to solve each and every. Right? Now see. 4 into 1 by 3. General question. 4 into 1. How much it is? 4 by 3. So given that 4 into 1 by 3, which is implies 4 into 1 equal to 4 into 1 by 3, which is implies 4 by 3. Observe here. 4 by 3 is the simplest form. Simplest form means 4 and 3 are co-prime. Class we discussed co-prime means the GCD of 4 and 3, or 3 and 4 is 1 only. Highest common factor, HCF. HCF of these two numbers is 1. Then we can say these two are co-primes. We cannot cancel these two. We cannot cancel these two because 4 is not multiple of 3 and 3 is not a multiple of 4. Both are different numbers. Okay? So whenever you get this type of fraction, is called simplest form. Now, this is an improper fraction because 4 by 3. So, we can convert into mixed fraction. How to do? Division. How to do? Division. Okay. Now, see. How to do division? Now, I am going to do here. Division. Fark. Let us see. 3, 4 by 3. 4 by 3 is nothing but I am doing here rough work. Okay. Now, let us see this here. We will do rough work. For the second problem, I am going to rough work 4 by 3. So, 4 divided by 3, 3 1 is 3. 4 minus 3 equal to 1. Okay, start from 1, go to 3. So, that means nothing but 1, 1 by 3. So, now which is implies 4 by 3 is equal to 1, 1 by 3. Understood everyone? So, therefore, 4 into 1 by 3 is equal to 1, 1 by 3. This is your solution. Now see that the next one, 5 into 2 by 9, 5 into 2 by 9, solution, 5 into 2 by 9, 5 into 2 by 9, which is implies 10 by 9. 10 and 9 both are coprimes. HCF of 10 and 9 is 1 only, because 10 is not a multiple of 9. 9 is not a multiple of 10. So which is implies this is an improper fraction. Again do the division, you will get the solution. 10 divided by 9. So 9 ones are 9. When you subtract 10 minus 9 equal to 1. Start from 1, go to the 9. So which is implies 1 by 9. So which is therefore 5 into 2 by 9 is equal to 1 by 9. Okay, this is your answer. This is your answer. You have to get that. Next one is 6th one. 5 by 2 into 6. See, 5 into 2 by 9 or 2 by 9 into 5. 2 3s are 6. 3 2s are also 6 only. So it is a multiply, it is a product. Either you can multiply 5 by 2 into 6 or 6 into 5 by 2, we will get the same answer. So now solution. So now here, given that 5 by 2 into 6, so which is implies, 5 into 6 divided by 2, 5 into 6, numerator into whole number. 5 6 are 30, 30 by 2. So now see this here, 30 is an even number, 2 is also an even number, and 30 is a multiple of 2. When you divide 30 with 2, what is the answer? See, let us discuss. 2 ones are 2, 1 is a remainder, 0 is a remainder, 2 5 are 10, remainder is 0. Okay, so when you divide 30 by 2, answer will become 15. So therefore, or you can cancel this, 2 ones are 2, 15. Either division or cancellation, both are same. So therefore, the answer will become 5 by 2 into 6 is equal to 15. Is equal to 15. Okay, now let us see that the 10th bit. 15 into 3 by 5. 15 into 3 by 5. So, solution. 15 into 3 by 5, which is equal to 15 into 3 by 5, which is implies 15 threes are 45. 45 divided by 5. Now observe here, 45 is a multiple of 5 because unit digit is 5. Now read the 5 table. 5 ones are 1, 5 2s are 10, 5 3s are 15, 5 4s are 5, 5s are 5, 6s are 5, 7s are 5, 8s are 40, 5 9s are 45. When you divide 45 with 5, the coefficient will become 9. That is your answer. Otherwise, you have to do here also, no problem. So, when you divide 45 with 5, 5 9s are 45 directly. So, the answer will become 0. So, therefore, or 5 1s are 5 9s are. Okay, this is equivalent. So, therefore, what is the answer? 15 into 3 by 5 become 9. Okay, so this is the process. Okay, right? If it is cancellation, we are going to do cancellation. Understood, everyone? See this here, 4 into 1 by 3 become 1 into 1 by 3 because I got an improper fraction converted into simple. This is called simplest form, 9 by 1. 9 is nothing but 9 by 1. 15 is nothing but 15 by 1. Mixed fraction. Multiply and reduce to lowest form and convert into a mixed fraction. Okay, so the lowest form, mixed fraction. Lowest form, mixed fraction. Lowest form, by cancellation we get whole number. Lowest form, by cancellation we get 9. Okay, I hope you understood this one, previous question and this one. Okay. Now, children, I hope you understood in the previous two questions. Now, let us discuss question number 5. Okay, question number 4, you are going to do homework. It is simple only. Okay, now, if you did not understand, we will discuss in the virtual class. Now, question number 5, first bit. 1 by 2 of two questions they give, 24 and 46. So, we are going to find out 1 by 2 of 24 and 1 by 2 of 46. Okay, how much the value? Let us discuss. First one, solution. Okay, given that 1 by 2 of 24. I am going to solve first one. 1 by 2 of 24. Half indicates in the previous class we discussed multiply. Okay, so which is implies 1 by 2 into 24. Okay, it's a whole number, it's a fraction, just multiply numerator into whole number, we will get 1 into 24 by 12. Sorry, 1 into divided by 2. Sorry. Here this 2 only, not 1 into 24 by 2, which is implies 1 into 24 is 24 only. 24 by 2. 24 is an even number. 2 is an even number. 24 is a multiple of 2. So we are going to solve here. Rougher I am going here. See, 24 when you divide by 2, what you are going to get the answer? 2 1s are 2, 0, 4 carry over here, 2 2s are 4. So what is the answer? 12. So we can cancellation also. 2 1s are 2, 2 1s are. If you are perfect in the table, so you get easily only. So therefore, what is the answer here? Therefore, 1 by 2 of 24 is equal to 12. Please don't be confused. Whenever you are going to get half, half indicates product or multiply. Second one I am going to solve. See, 1 by 2 of 46. 1 by 2 of 46. Again, half is nothing but multiply. So which is implies 1 by 2 into 46. Same process. Multiply 1 into 46 by 2. Which is implies 46 by 2. Again, 46 is an even number. Divide with 2. When you divide 46 with 2, 2 2s are 4. 0. This will become 6. Okay, 6 will come down. 2 3s are 6, remainder will be 0. Answer is how much? 23. So 2 1s are 2, 23 is are, which is equal to 1 by 2 of, so therefore 1 by 2 of 46 is equal to 23. I hope understood. Half, OF half is nothing but, not HALF, OF, OF half is nothing but multiply. This is clear, my dear. Okay. I hope you understood how to multiply. Okay. Half is nothing but half of the 46 means 23. Simple calculations. Okay. Don't be confused. Now, children, the same question, in fifth question, I'm going to solve one more bit. That is C1. 3 by 4 of, first question is 16. Second one is 36. Okay, now see, same process. Half means multiply. Now first one is given that first one is 3 by 4 of 16. Okay, half means multiply. 3 by 4 into 16, which is implies 3 into 16 by 4. 3 16s are, or 16 3s are 48. 48 by 4. 48 is an even number, 4 is an even number, and 48 is a multiple of 4. Let us see here. And of course, I am going to divide 48 with 4. 4 1s are 4, so 0, and 8 will be come down. 4 2s are 8. So, what is the answer here? 12. 4s are 48. So by cancellation also you will get 12 is the answer. So therefore, what is the answer? 3 by 4 part of 3 by 4 of 16 is equal to 12. 16 is equal to 12. Clear? Very good. Now 3 by 4 of 16 is equal to 12. Now let us discuss 36. How much part of 3 by 4 from 36? Okay, now second one. 3 by 4 of 36. Okay, same process.
3 by 4 into 36, which is implies 3 into 36 by 4. Now what is the value of 3 into 36? It's a big number. We need to do calculation here. 36 into 3, 3 6 is 18. 1 carry over. 3 is 9 plus 1, 10. 108. So which is implies 108 divided by 4. Now divide 108 divided by 4 because 108 is an even number. So when you divide 108 with 4, what will be the coefficient? 4 to the 8, 10 minus 8 equal to 2. Come down, 8 is down, and 4, 7 the 28, answer will become 27. 27 4 the 108, 4 1 the 4, 27, which is equal to 27. So therefore, 3 by 4 of 36 is equal to 27. Okay, so there are totally 36 parts are there. Out of 36, 3 by 4 parts, nothing but 27 will get. Understood everyone? 3 by 4 of 36 is equal to 27. 3 by 4 of 16 is equal to 12. I hope you understood today's solutions, whatever we discussed. First question based on question and figure. Second, third question we discussed. Mixed fraction and simplest form. Okay, and fifth question. Okay, now today's homework. I'll write on the board. You please note down the homework and complete the homework in classwork only. Okay, if there is any doubt, we will discuss in the virtual class. Okay. Now, children, I hope you understood today's whatever we discussed the problems. Now, here is your homework. So, textbook page number 36 and 37. Exercise 2.2. Question number 2 full. Because question number 1 I did already. So, based on question number 1 only, you have question number 2. And in question number 3, I explained 4 sums. Out of 10, 4 explained. So, the remaining 6 you have 1, 3, first question, third bit, 5th, 7th, 8th, and 9th. Clear? Now, question number 4 again full. It is only picturized, it is just only shaded part, you will do easily. Now, question number 5, B and D, because A and C I explained, B and D. Okay, I hope you understood today's class. And if anybody have any doubt, you can call me, that is my WhatsApp number, it is in group only. Okay, if you have any doubt, you can send through WhatsApp also. Okay, please take care. Thank you very much.